Good morning. In today's session, we are going to see about the fundamentals of clustering and its types. So let us get into the session. Before knowing what is a clustering, we'll have an outline of the presentation. So today we are going to see what is a cluster and the examples of clustering, followed by the clustering of applications and the types of clustering. And finally, we are going to see what are all the different techniques we have in the clustering. So before knowing what is a cluster, simply we can say the cluster is nothing but it is used for discovering the patterns based on the shape, size and color. So we'll just look into that. The cluster is a collection of data objects. So in other words we can say partitioning or grouping the data points based on the similarity. Simply, the cluster is an example, or it can be classified as the unsupervised learning techniques. So the major difference, that is the key difference in clustering, is it does not have any response classes, which means after grouping the observations, human needs to visually look at the clusters and optionally associate the meaning for each other. The general definition of clustering goes like this. The process of grouping a set of physical or abstract objects into a classes of similar object called clustering. So in this slide we are going to see what is an unsupervised learning, since we can say that clustering is an example or it is classified as an unsupervised learning. So here we have an example. So in this example you can visualize, you have the fruits in one side, and in another side we can see the fruits, how it has been classified. So image of fruits is first fed into the system, then the system identifies the different fruits using their features like color, size, and then it categorizes them. When a new fruit is shown, the system analyzes and put into the category having the similar featured items. So this is generally called as unsupervised learning. So this unsupervised learning is also called as learning by observations rather than learning by examples. So we can easily say the clustering is a type of unsupervised learning method. So here we can see how this clustering is working. So here we have a group of diners in a restaurant. So in this example, let us consider we have two tables, the table T1 and another table called T2. So the set of people in table T1 does not mix up with the set of people with table T2, because the T1 and T2 are the separate groups or separate members. So the members of the table T1 will not mix up with the members of the table T2. Another example is used for understanding the working of the clustering. Here the items arranged in a supermarket. You can see the same, you can see the different varieties of fruits are placed, and these varieties of fruits does not mix up with any other varieties. So this is how your clustering will be working. So we can group the data points or we can group the elements into a similar cluster, but the different cluster dissimilar to the objects in another clusters. So in this slide you are going to see what is an example of clustering. So here you have a scattered document. So after applying the clustering algorithm, you can see the different set of clusters. So here we have n number of data points. After applying the clustering techniques, we are grouping these data points into different clusters. So this is an example for your clustering. So next we are going to see where we are going to use this type of clustering. So the clustering is mainly used in the market research, pattern recognition, data analysis, image processing and information discovery. So we have many more areas, but I have listed only the few. So next is the types of clustering. So under the types of clustering, we are going to see the three different types of clustering. One is the exclusive clustering, second one is overlapping clustering, and the third one will be the hierarchical clustering. So we'll see one by one in the forthcoming slide. So the exclusive clustering. So this exclusive clustering is also called as hard clustering, where the data points belong exclusively to one cluster, which means the data points in one cluster does not depend on the data points of other cluster. So that type of clustering is called as exclusive clustering. So example for this exclusive clustering will be the k-means clustering. Now we can see an example of exclusive clustering. So we have two different types of cluster, the blue cluster and the pink cluster. You can see the data points blue cluster does not belong to the data points in the pink cluster. So this is an example of your exclusive cluster. Next is overlapping clustering. This overlapping clustering is also called as the soft clusters, where the data points belong to the multiple clusters. So the example of overlapping cluster will be the C-means clustering or the fuzzy clustering. So we can see how the overlapping clustering will be. So the data points in the blue cluster belong to some of the data points in the pink cluster. So this type of mechanism is called as an overlapping clustering. That is, this data points will have some features related to the pink clusters. Have seen what is a clustering, a hierarchical clustering. In the same way to arrive the hierarchy, so the agglomerative method is called as bottom up approach and the flexible method is called as top down approach. Here the similar way, we'll start with one cluster and we'll be including all the inclusive clusters. At each steps we are going to split a cluster until we are going to reach a single cluster containing a point. So the examples of this hierarchical clustering is Cure, Birch, etc. So this is the example for your divisive clustering. So from the root will be going down. So this is the example for divisive clustering. So this is called as level 1 and this part is called as level 2 and this part is called as level 3 and this part is called as level. So next is the density based methods. So in the density, clustering is formed based on the density, such as density connected points. So we'll be measuring the density of the clusters and we'll be grouping the clusters into different clusters. So we are going to discover the clusters based on the arbitrary space. The main example for this density based method is the DB scan method. So this is the most popular density based methods. So here we have an example for this density based methods. So based on the density, we are going to group the data points into various clusters. This is the example for your density based methods.